Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're taking a look at a new service, to me at least, called Listen Later. What Listen Later does is it takes articles from the web, turns them into podcast episodes that you can listen to in whatever podcast app you happen to use. It's really cool. It's definitely fresh. It's definitely a little rough around the edges and isn't as easy to use as I'd love it to be down the road, but part of this channel is looking at new and interesting things and seeing what concepts are cool. And I really like this concept of listening to articles. I do it in Readwise Reader. I think Omnivore has the best version of this. But what's cool about Listen Later is it puts it in your podcast app, which one, means it's going to be downloaded. So if you're offline, you can still listen to things. And two, it's where I'm already listening to other stuff anyway. So it's just there for me where I already am. And that's really convenient. So let's take a look at it. I'll talk about pricing. I'll talk about how it works. And I'll save an article and give you an idea for how it sounds. Okay, so here we are on the web, and I'm looking at their homepage, which again, a little rough and ready, but not the end of the world. Let's jump to pricing first to give you an idea. The features are basically just what I explained to you in the intro. But yeah, basically you can start for free. There's $2 in free credits. You don't have to put a credit card on file or anything to start. You just get going. And what do credits do? Well, it's basically using OpenAI's text-to-speech engine, which costs money. So long story short, you're paying for that, and you get $2 for free. I've been able to use my $2 to save a good amount of stuff. I've saved like 5 or 6 articles and not gone through them, but it is a pay-as-you-go sort of situation. So we'll get more into that, but let's close this private window. And here we are on my account. And you can see basically, this is what you're gonna see after you set up, sign up. So give me your email address, I think you create a password, and then you're in. So on the homepage, again, very minimal, but it works. They're gonna give you this link you can copy and paste into the podcast player of your choice. If I go into Overcast, what you're gonna do is go here, go to the plus, and then add URL. And then you're just gonna paste it here, add it, it's gonna show up as a podcast. If I scroll down a little bit, you can see I have Listen Later. I've got a couple episodes here. It's downloading them, and then I've got more here. So this is what, basically what my $2 has gotten me. So like 8 episodes or so. But yeah, it varies based on how long the things are and everything. But regardless, you basically just get this link, open it in your podcast app, and then subscribe there. And how it works from then on is you need to send emails to or from the email address you signed up with, send them to this email address, and then here's the credits. So that's basically it. If you go into the settings, there's a couple voices I let you choose from. Echo is my favorite, but you can listen to them. And then once you've chosen one, do choose this voice. There's an HD voice option, which I cannot tell the difference. So I'm just using normal one because the HD voice costs more money. You can set it to a specific speed. It's going to a podcast player, so you should really just do 1x speed. And if you want to change the speed, I'd recommend doing that in your podcast player. You can add some music at the start of this end. And it can actually translate podcasts for you into other languages. I have not played with that, but that could be interesting. But yeah, so here's the pricing, which is exactly what we just looked at. If I go to buy credits, yeah, it looks like you can buy them in $5, $10, or $20 amounts. But anyway, let's go ahead and see how this works. So let's say I want to save this article. Let me just go ahead and save that or copy it to my clipboard. And let's open my email app, start a new email. And so it just needs to go to save@listenlater.me. This is sending from my correct email address. The subject line does not matter. You just paste in the link. I believe you can only do one link per email. I tried doing multiple links in one email. It didn't do multiple episodes for me. I think it just picked the first one. So this is all I do. And we'll go ahead and send that. It's going to send in a couple seconds here. And I'll switch over to showing you my phone in a sec so we can listen to the episode. Okay, so it's been about 3 minutes, and I have the episode in my podcast player. You can see this is Obsidian Launcher. And if we look at my balance, it cost me about 29 cents in credits to do this article. So for reference, this article is this long. There's a decent amount of stuff here. And yeah, so not the shortest article, not the longest either, but about 29 cents. So about 15% of the free credits that you would have gotten when you started up. And let's just let it play for a couple seconds so you can get an idea for what it sounds like. I'm just going to fade the video out as this ends. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you here next time.
2 years ago, we released Obsidian Shortcut Launcher, a free plugin to trigger shortcuts from Obsidian with the ability to pass input text to Apple's automation app. In case you missed it, in January 2022, here's how I describe the plugin. With Obsidian Shortcut Launcher, or OSL, you'll be able to trigger any shortcut you want from Obsidian, passing along values such as the text of the document you're working on, its name, text selection, and more. Obsidian Shortcut Launcher is free to use and works on iOS, iPadOS, and macOS. Obsidian Shortcut Launcher is the result of weeks of planning and work from me and Finn Voorhees, and it has created an entirely new dimension in how I use Obsidian and shortcuts on a daily basis.